Well, Mewtwo, it's been a good long wait, but finally you are returning to Super Smash Bros. Are you excited?
Indeed I am. After it was revealed that Greninja would be appearing, as well as Charizard, Pikachu and Lucario were returning, I had high doubts that I would be returning as well.
Yes, but at least now you can finally enjoy the modern version of Smash Bros, and you even have a counter to go alongside it as well. That reminds me, Chris, why is it that Greninja's counter isn't on this series?
The reason is simply because of Lucina's counter. Since her counter covers all forms of counter-attacks, and since Greninja's substitute is classed as a counter, there's no point in having the substitute counter appear as well.
Yes, that does make sense.
Correct me if I'm mistaken, but can't that same logic be said about my counter? Why not just have the power-up counter for all Mega Evolutions?
That actually was the original plan, but when it was confirmed you was going to be returning to Smash Bros, it made much more sense to throw your counter in as well. Sure, I could have included Greninja's counter if I wanted to, but since he's the only character in the entire roster that uses Substitute, it simply isn't worth bringing the counter in just for one character. Plus, if you ask me, it would feel weird having the power-up counter for Mega Evolutions. It just does not feel right.
Alright then, enough talk. It's time I got into the Smash Bros. Action.
Alright, let's do this.
Hello everybody, it's Nintendo's Commander, and welcome to episode 10 of Super Smash Bros. For Nintendo Wii U. So finally, Mewtwo has returned to Super Smash Bros. It's been a good long time, I must say, but finally, he has returned, and hopefully, for good. I'm going to be honest with you people, I really hope they never boycott him in the first place. I mean, when I played Super Smash Bros. Brawl, I wasn't actually aware that Mewtwo was a playable character in Melee, but then when I found out that he was in Melee and then cut from Brawl, it did really surprise me because Mewtwo is pretty iconic in the Pokemon community, and since Pokemon is pretty iconic in Nintendo in general, it did surprise me as to them cutting Mewtwo from Smash Bros. Brawl in favour of Lucario. Now, for this episode, rather than narrating the gameplay, I decided to dedicate the entire episode to talking about Mewtwo. So, I want to go through his history, my personal opinions on the Pokemon, what I think should be done with him in the future, and just overall, talking about anything Mewtwo related. So, let's get into it. So really, who is Mewtwo? Where does he come from? What's his backstory? And exactly why is he such a popular character in the Pokemon universe? Mewtwo debuted in the very first Pokemon games, Pokemon Red and Pokemon Blue, and of course Pokemon Red and Green in Japan, if you understand your localization details. Now, ever since the very first Pokemon games, Mewtwo has remained a very strong presence. He's always been one of the most overpowered Pokemon ever to be featured in the Pokemon video games, and from the looks of things, that's not going to change anytime soon. While it is true that for the most part Mewtwo remained unchanged in the first 5 generations, it was Generation 6 that really gave Mewtwo the boosts in terms of power by introducing Mega Evolutions. Mewtwo gained 2 Mega Evolutions in Pokemon X and Y, both of which are extremely powerful and quite frankly are really overpowered. But Mewtwo has always been that anyway, so it doesn't really matter if they make him even more powerful than he already is. Some have also argued that the reason Mewtwo gained 2 Mega Evolutions was purely out of fan service, which I completely understand, and to be honest, considering Charizard also got 2 Mega Evolutions as well, it does not surprise me that they would give these 2 Pokemon in particular such a huge amount of attention. Next to Pikachu, Charizard and Mewtwo are arguably the most popular
Pokemon in the series, and there's very few that are as popular as those two are. So going back to Mewtwo. Mewtwo was supposedly created by a single scientist. While we don't actually know the details as to who created Mewtwo, there is a lot of theories going around saying that Mr. Fuji, who you do meet during your Pokemon Kanto adventure, was the one that created Mewtwo. There is no solid evidence supporting this, but it is believed that Mr. Fuji was the creator of Mewtwo. But that's pure speculation, we can't say that for absolute definite. So Mewtwo is basically a clone of the original Mew. Now you would think, if you're not familiar with the lore to Mewtwo, that because he's only a clone, he's basically identical to Mew. But obviously, taking a good look at his appearance, you'll see that Mewtwo does look quite different to Mew. He's a lot taller for starters, he's got a bigger tail, his face looks a bit different. There's a number of different, you know, aspects to Mewtwo that separate him from Mew. But another gigantic difference is how much stronger Mewtwo is over Mew. Mew is a pretty good Pokemon, capable of learning every move, well, any move that can be learned anyway. While Mewtwo, on the other hand, has a lot higher in terms of offensive stats, it's a lot faster, a lot more powerful offensively, and it's more defensive as well. Really, when it comes to stats, Mewtwo has Mew beaten all around. The reason for this was the people that cloned Mew didn't just clone Mew, but they also somehow, using various techniques, was able to make Mewtwo even stronger than the original. Again, it's not clear exactly how they did this. There is a load of data within the Pokemon games explaining what the process was of capturing Mew, then cloning Mewtwo, etc. But they don't really go into the in-depth details. Probably because it was pretty unnecessary, given the fact that Pokemon originally was aimed at kids, and there wouldn't really be any reason to in-depth explore the history to Mewtwo and exactly the meticulous process was of making Mewtwo. That said, the movie certainly does go into much more details than the games do, but again, the movie and the games are completely separated. They literally take place in separate universes. The Mewtwo that's in the video games is nothing to do with the Mewtwo of the movie. The only thing that they share is a similar plot, except the movie takes a rather drastic turn compared to the games. So that's pretty much the backstory to Mewtwo. Now, after Mewtwo was created, it was supposed that eventually they were unable to control the creature, so ultimately it broke free from the lab and then just went traveling. We don't even know exactly where Mewtwo went or what happened. But sooner or later, after you've beaten the Elite Four as the Pokemon trainer you play as, you get the option to go up against Mewtwo and capture the Pokemon for yourself. Kind of ironic really, considering the fact that a whole science lab of scientists wasn't able to contain Mewtwo, but a 10-year-old boy with a few Pokeballs is able to keep the monster under tame. So, yeah. Why they didn't just capture Mewtwo in a regular Pokeball or whatever people use to capture them in is beyond me, but hey, that's Pokemon storylines for you. So I've talked quite a bit about the story side of things, so let's move away from that now and move into why Mewtwo is so powerful, why does he break the Pokemon games, and why do we love the Pokemon so much? Well, to tell you the truth, obviously the first aspect to why people love Mewtwo so much is his design. Now for me, yeah, Mewtwo's design is awesome. I really like the way they structured him, the way they made him kind of human-like, but at the same time he looks like a Pokemon, and in my opinion they did a really good job making him the way they did. You must forgive me, I'm not very good at describing actual designs, but if I had to comment on Mewtwo's design, I would say that he's probably the best example of what would happen if a Pokemon was to be infused with human technology. It kind of looks like a human, but at the same time doesn't look like a human, and he's basically a Pokemon that takes on human-like features. and considering his backstory, that does make sense to me. He was ultimately created by scientists, who of course are humans, and based on that, I feel his design really does bring that out, if that makes sense to anyone. So as for Mewtwo as a character in the Pokemon games, Mewtwo, as I've said several times already, is a very powerful presence. He's got some of the highest stats in the entire game and is literally quite broken for the most part. He kind of breaks the game and is considered to be so powerful he's not even allowed in standard Pokemon battles or standard competitive battles because he's deemed to be way too powerful for the fair conditions. Unfortunately, Mewtwo is a testament to how unbalanced Pokemon actually is. Now, I myself love Pokemon. It's a really fun game and I do really enjoy playing it. But there's no denying, Pokemon is one of the most unbalanced games ever designed. There are some Pokemon that are simply nowhere near good enough as they could be. Some Pokemon are pretty good at what they do. Then there's some Pokemon that are ridiculously overpowered and are hardly fair to go up against. Mewtwo is pretty much the latter, and that's the main reason why he's banned from standard Pokemon battles. But that said, we all still love him. We love his power, we love his appearance, we love the way he plays. There's pretty much nothing that he can't do. There's a very few things he probably can't do. He's not particularly good at physical attacking because of his limited physical move pool, but he doesn't really need it, to be honest. His special attacks more than make up for it, and combine that with his ridiculous speed stat, Mewtwo is a force to be reckoned with, and anybody that goes up against this kind of creature will need to be very careful, because he is really powerful. So, speaking of how powerful he is, how does he fare in the Smash Bros. Game? Well, crazy as this is, despite his strong presence in the normal Pokemon games, in Smash Bros. Melee, Mewtwo was actually considered to be one of the worst characters in the entire game. Now, I can't say too much about this from my perspective, because I haven't played Smash Bros. Melee. I probably will in the future, but at present I have not played that game. And so I can only really go up by what people have told me, but people have basically told me Mewtwo is awful in that game. The way he plays just isn't very appealing. He leaves a lot to be desired, and essentially, he's just not very good to use, which is like a complete opposite to how he is in the Pokemon games. It's like they took all that strength, turned it into a weakness, and the end result was Mewtwo in Smash Bros. Melee. So really, I can't say too much about how he is in Melee, because as I've said, I haven't played that game. But as for this game, does Mewtwo hold up quite well? In my opinion, yes. As of recording this video, I've already had quite a few matches playing as Mewtwo, and I have to say, this is a character that I definitely am going to start using in my videos, because I pretty much wanted him to become my main Pokemon in the game. Prior to Mewtwo's release, the main Pokemon I was using was actually Greninja, because he's my second favorite Pokemon since Mewtwo came out. And I really wanted Mewtwo to be my new main Pokemon, and has he reached that? Yes, but at the same time, I can't say Mewtwo is what I expected. To be honest, Mewtwo's gameplay and the way that he moves, the way how floaty he feels, it's quite unorthodox. It is actually quite unorthodox in the way he plays, and if you're really used to some of the other characters in the game, and you haven't played Melee like me, he is going to feel a bit awkward to get used to. Now, since I've played with Mewtwo quite a bit, I definitely can say the character can be used really well. And I've already managed to squeeze in quite a few cool wins with Mewtwo myself. I'm not saying by any means I'm a good player. I actually am quite bad at this game in the grand scheme of things. But I do have to say, this is the type of character that might feel a bit awkward when you're first playing as him. But hey, I still think it works. And I definitely do agree that in the right hands, Mewtwo can be a force to be reckoned with. Now, is he top tier in this game? Well, to tell you the truth, tiers are something that I have a very unpopular opinion about. To be perfectly honest, I'm not really a fan of tiers, to be perfectly honest. And yes, I know tiers are somewhat believable, there are some characters that are better than others, but for me, I don't like to let that determine who I use and who I don't use. I pretty much just use whoever I feel like. The only time I don't use a character, even though I like them, is if I flat out don't like how they play. For example, I don't like playing as Ness. I really like Ness as a character, but I don't like using him because I'm not comfortable with how he plays. Or at least not right now, anyway. Now, with Mewtwo, I certainly can adjust to how he plays. As I'm sure you've noticed right now, I'm not playing the best with Mewtwo. These matches were actually recorded on the day Mewtwo was released, so that's probably why I'm not doing very well with him in these videos. But hey, as of right now I'm recording this, have I gotten better with Mewtwo? I think I have, but I'm still not amazing with Mewtwo, if you know what I mean. Now the last thing I want to touch basis on before we end this video is actually a lot longer than usual. I wanted to make this one a bit lengthy because, well, I just wanted to make it extra lengthy. There is no real reason, I just felt like recording a lot of matches with Mewtwo and giving you guys a bit more than what I normally give you. So, yeah, that's pretty much the reason. But, the last thing I want to talk about is, did we actually need Mewtwo as DLC? I would just like to say for the record, no. To be perfectly honest, I've said this even before Mewtwo was announced. We don't really need any more characters. At this point in time, I feel the character roster is fine as it is. Now I would be completely lying if I said there are no characters I want in this game. Believe me, if I went through an entire list of all the characters I would like to see in this game, the list would be huge. But at the same time, we don't really need any more characters. You know, when you count Mewtwo, we have over 50 playable characters, and that's quite a lot. I was expecting this game to pretty much be about the same as Brawl, but about 10 more slots. So pretty much Brawl's roster, plus about 10 more characters. But this is amazing. Even without Mewtwo, I still think this game has done a really good job in giving us a good character roster. Even considering the clones and everything into account, I still feel this is the best roster we've had in a Smash Bros. Game. And even without Mewtwo, there was still plenty of Pokemon and plenty of characters in general to give the game a lot of variety. So, in my opinion at this point, am I against DLC? Absolutely not. I love it when a new character gets added. I'm excited to see what Lucas is going to be like when he gets released next month. But at the same time, it's like, new additions aren't good, but they're not needed. The roster is perfectly fine without the DLC characters. All the DLC characters are a nice bonus or a nice addition, whatever you want to call it. It's basically they are good to have, but at the same time I feel they are not needed. Now there will be people that disagree with me on that. Some people say we need to have Wolf back. I actually want Wolf to come back because I loved playing as Wolf in the previous game. But do we need him? No, certainly not. We don't need Wolf in this game. We already have two Star Fox representatives, and I feel that's fine. At this point, Wolf would just be a nice addition to the character roster. But we don't need him by any means. I'd be perfectly fine if he doesn't make it in. So, that's all I can really say about that. Now, at the same time, you know, are there any other characters I would like to see get added to DLC? Well, that's pretty much been saved for a future video. I actually already talked about this in my Smash Bros. Ballot video, which you can go check out. It's in the videos list if you want to watch that already. Mind you, knowing you, you probably already have seen it if you are watching this video. Unless, of course, you're a newcomer to my channel. But do I don't think we need more characters in this game. I think it's perfectly fine as is. But at the same time, I do feel that any new characters, they are welcome, but they're not needed. That's all I can say about that. So we are actually approaching the end of the video now. So of course this is where you guys come in. You know, why did you want Mewtwo in this game? If you were somebody and you were like me and you did want Mewtwo in this game, then what are your reasons for liking him? Why did you want him to come back? And if you agree with everything I said in this video, then let me know in the comment box down below, or just give the video a thumbs up if you agree with everything that I have said. So I'm just watching this match between myself and R.O.B. This is actually quite close, believe it or not, and I can't really say much else about Mewtwo. I've pretty much said everything there is to say, and at this point, considering how long this video has turned out to be, I have run out of stuff to talk about. You know, I could talk about something else, but hey, there's not really much point because we're about to approach the end. And am I going to win this battle? I actually can't remember because it's been a while since I recorded this. And gotta say that this Mewtwo alternate, this alternate for Mewtwo is actually pretty cool. I must admit, this is one of the color skins for Mewtwo that I really like. But I'm gonna lose in it. So victory goes to R.O.B, I guess. So if you want to leave a comment down below or a thumbs up, then go ahead and feel free to do so. I will see you guys in the next video, and peace out. Thanks for watching.